Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in AutoCAD 2018 in Imperial. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_031_DIABWICVIT. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save as icon. Save this drawing as 00_032_DIAB. Click the save icon. In this tutorial we're going to start to model our windows. First, let's start to create a profile around the window. Right click the UCS and select face. As select the face of solid, surface or mesh point, upload the mouse cursor into this face and click. Let's enter to accept the orientation. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the rectangle command. At the specified first corner point, zoom in into this area. Use the object snap to snap at the vertex of this window. At the specified other corner point, move the mouse cursor and hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Zoom in and snap into this area. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the visual control and click the realistic. Select 2D wireframe. Select the rectangle that you just drew, right click into the drawing area, isolate objects. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the line command. At a specified first point, use the midpoint object and snap to the midpoint of this rectangle. Move the mouse cursor down and snap to the midpoint of this line. Press enter to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, layer panel and click the layer properties. This will bring the layer property manager. Click the new icon, name this icon to 3D window. Click the color swatches to bring the select color dialog box. Select the index color 250 and click OK. Go to the new layer, click the new layer button again to create another layer. Rename this layer to window glass. Click the color switches to open the select color dialog box. In the select color dialog box, click the color book tab. Click this down arrow and look for let's try and see real design. Select trial 2606005. You can also type the number here. Click OK. Close the layer properties manager. Now go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset corner. At a specified offset distance point, type 3 inches on your keyboard and press enter. Select the this rectangle and offset it inside. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the 3D window. Go to the 3D tools tab, solid edit panel and select the press pull command. At the select object or bounded area prompt, select this rectangle, move it out and type 3 inches on your keyboard. Press enter. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the visual style control. Click the 2D wireframe and select realistic. Now select this line and hit delete on the keyboard. Go to the 3D tools tab, solid edit panel and select the press pull command. At the select object or bounded area prompt, click inside this object and press it out. Press escape to get out of the corner. Now type oops on your keyboard to bring back the deleted object. Zoom in into this area and hold down the shift key to orbit. Go to the home tab, layer panel and select the make current. Select this line. Now the cabbage layer is the current layer. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the line command. At the specified start point prompt, move the mouse cursor and snap into this endpoint. Move the mouse cursor into this direction. Type 0.5, press enter. Type 1 inch, press enter. 1 inch, press enter. 0.5, press enter. Press enter to end the command. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. At the specified offset distance, at the specified offset distance point, type 1 inch on your keyboard and press enter. Now, offset this line to the right and select this line and offset it to the left. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select this solid and hit delete on your keyboard. Use a window selection to select this line. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the copy command. Add a specified base point point. Move, click on this endpoint. Zoom in into this area and click on this endpoint. Add a specified second point point. Move your mouse cursor and snap to the intersection of this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Type oops on your keyboard to bring back the deleted objects. Go to the Home tab, Draw panel, and select the line command. Add a specified first point point. Move the mouse cursor into this area and click in the at this intersection. Go to the status bar and turn on your auto mode. Move the line into this direction and type points 5. Press enter. Press enter to get out of the command. Now select the 3D solid and hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the rectangle command. Zoom in into this area and start the rectangle into this line that you just draw. Move the mouse cursor down and snap into this line. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 2 inches on your keyboard. Press enter. Select this rectangle and offset it inside. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select this rectangle. Hold down the control key and the shift key. Type letter C on your keyboard. At the specified base point point, move your mouse cursor and snap into this area. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the 3D tools tab, modeling panel, and select the extrude command. Add a select object to extrude point. Select this rectangle and this rectangle. Press enter. Add a specified height of extrusion point. Move the mouse cursor into this direction and type 1 inch on your keyboard. Press enter. Go to the visual style and click realistic. Select 2D wireframe. Go to the 3D tools tab, solid edit panel, and select the subtract command. Zoom in into this area. At the select object point, select this rectangle, press enter. At the select object point, select the internal rectangle and press enter. AutoCAD subtract the external rectangle. AutoCAD subtract the internal rectangle from the external rectangle. Go to the visual style control and change the visual style to realistic. Type oops on your keyboard to bring back the object you deleted recently. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the match property. At the select source object point, select the external frame. At the select destination object point, select the internal frame. Press escape to get out of the command. Now let's bring back the rectangle we had recently. Let's bring back the rectangle that we copy on the clipboard. To do that, hold down your control key and type V. At the specify insertion point point, move the mouse cursor and use the endpoint object snap to snap in this vertex. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the visual style and change it back to 2D wireframe. Select this rectangle, go to the 3D tools tab, modeling panel, and select the extrude command. At the specified extrusion height point, move your mouse cursor inside and type 2.5. Press enter. Zoom in into this area. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the move command. Select the solid that you just created and press enter. At the specified base point, use the midpoint object snap and snap at this edge. At the specifying second point point, use the midpoint object snap again and snap at the midpoint of this frame. Go to the visual style and change it back to realistic. Now select this panel, go to the layer panel and move this panel to, go to the layer panel and move this object into glass, window glass. Press escape to get out of the command. Now we need to mirror this object into the opposite direction. Select this glass. Now go to the view control and click the custom view. Select top. Now go to the view control and click the custom view. Select front. Select this solid and this solid. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the mirror command. At the specifying first point of mirror line, use the midpoint object snap and snap into this area. Now move your mouse cursor down and snap. Press enter to accept the default. Hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Go to the visual style and change it back to 2D wireframe. Now this is a slide window. We need to move one of the window inside so that it can overlap one another. Select this solid, these two solid. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the Move command. Zoom in into this area. At the specified base point prompt, click here. At the specified second point prompt, move the mouse cursor and snap into this point. Go to the visual style and change it back to realistic to see the result. Now, select this solid, right click in the drawing area, isolate object, hide object. Select this solid, right click in the drawing area, isolate object, hide object. Now select all these objects, hit your delete key on your keyboard. Right click the UCS and select wall. Right click in the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. So let's go and grid the one of the toilet window and the single window. I will leave the rest of window for you as an exercise. Zoom in into this area and right click the UCS. Select the face option. Hover the mouse cursor into this face and click. Press enter to accept. Make sure that your cabbage layer is the current layer. Go to the Home tab, Draw panel, and select the rectangle corner. At the specified first corner point prompt, zoom in into this area and use the end object snap to snap in this vertex. At the specifying other corner point prompt, move the mouse cursor in this area. Hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit to get a better orientation. You can also hold down the middle mouse button to pan your drawing a little bit and roll the mouse forward to zoom in. Click. Now, go to the visual style, select 2D wireframe. Select the rectangle that you just drew. Right click in the drawing area, isolate objects. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 3 inches on your keyboard and press enter. At the select object to offset prompt, select this rectangle and offset it inside. Press escape to get out of the command. Hold down Ctrl plus Shift and type C on your keyboard. At the specified base point prompt, click at this endpoint. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the 3D tools tab, modeling panel, and select the extrude command. Select all two of the rectangle and press enter. Move the mouse cursor inside and type 3 inches. Press enter to end the command. Go to the Home tab, solid edit panel, and select the subtract command. At the select object to subtract, select the external solid. Press enter. At the select object, select the internal solid. Press enter. AutoCAD subtract the internal solid from the external solid. Now select this object, change its layer to 3D windows. Press escape to get out of the command. Now let's bring back the rectangle that we copy in the clipboard. Hold down your control key and type V. At the specifying base point form, use the endpoint object snap and snap into the vertex of this solid. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select this solid, right click, isolate, hide object. Go to the Home tab, Draw panel, and select the line command. At the specifying first point prompt, use the midpoint object as snap and use the midpoint object as snap again. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 1 inch on your keyboard and press enter. Select and offset this line to the right. Select and offset this to the left. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the rectangle command. At the specifying first point prompt, select at this corner and move your mouse cursor and snap to this corner. Press enter to start the rectangle again. Select from this corner and snap to this corner. We need to delete the external rectangle, but it's difficult because this rectangle and this one overlap the external one. So to accomplish that, use a crossing window and select from this area. Hold down your shift key and click more than halfway the object and click again to deselect. Now click delete on your keyboard, zoom in into this area and hit delete again. Now we have two rectangles overlap each other. Select the two rectangles, go to the home tab, modify panel and select the move command. At the specified base point prompt, click on this endpoint and move the mouse cursor into this direction. Type 0.5 inches on your keyboard and press enter. Press enter to repeat the move command again. At the select object prompt, select one of the rectangle and press enter. At the specified base point prompt, select this rectangle and move into this area. Type 1 inch, press enter. Hold down your shift key and orbit around. Select this line and hit delete on your keyboard. Now go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. At the specified offset distance point, type 2 inches on your keyboard, press enter. Select this rectangle and offset it inside. Select this rectangle and offset, press enter. Now select this rectangle, hold down Ctrl plus Shift and type C on your keyboard. At the specified base point prompt, click on this area. Go to the 3D Tools tab, Modeling panel and select the Extrude command. Select all of this object and press Enter. Move the mouse cursor into this direction. At the specified Extrusion Height prompt, type 1 inch on your keyboard and press Enter. Let's change the visual style to realistic to see the results. Now go to the change it back to 2D wireframe. Go to the 3D Tools tab, Solid Edit panel and select the Subtract command. Select this object, press Enter and select this solid, press Enter. Press Enter again to repeat the Subtract command. Select this solid, press Enter and select this solid, press Enter. I think during the extrusion, we extrude a line by mistake. That's why we have a surface in this area. So we don't need this surface. Go ahead and select this surface if you have the same situation and hit delete on your keyboard. Now change the view back to realistic to see the results. Select the two objects and move them to the 3D windows layer. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the hold down your control key and type letter V on your keyboard. At the specified initiation point form, select, move the mouse cursor and use the endpoint object now. Snap into this vertex. Change the visual style back to 2D wireframe. Select this rectangle. Go to the 3D Tools tab, Modeling panel and select the Extrude command. At the specified extrusion height, move into this direction and type 0.25, press Enter. Now select this solid and this solid. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the move command. At the specified base point prompt, zoom in into this area and snap at the edge of this solid. Move the mouse cursor and snap here. Select this solid and move it to the window glass layer. Now click in this area and use a crossing window to select this line. Hold down your shift key and click on this solid to deselect it. Hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the visual style and change it back to realistic. Now right click in the drawing area, isolate and object isolation. Next, let's create a slide door for the right click the UCS and select the face option. At the select face of solid, surface or mesh prompt, click on this area. Press enter to accept. Now go to the home tab, draw panel and select the rectangle command. At the specified start point prompt, use the endpoint object and snap to this vertex. Hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit and snap into this vertex. Go to the visual style control, click realistic, select 2D wireframe. Zoom in into this area, select this rectangle, right click in the drawing area, isolate objects. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 3 inches on your keyboard and press enter. Select the rectangle and offset it inside. Press escape to get out of the command. Select this rectangle, hold down the shift control and type letter C on your keyboard. At the specified base point prompt, you zoom in into this area and click. Go to the 3D tools tab, modeling panel, and select the extrude command. At the select object to extrude point, select both of the rectangle, press enter. Move the mouse cursor in the negative Z direction and type 4 inches on your keyboard, press enter. Go to the 3D tools tab, solid edit panel, and select the subtract command. At the select object prompt, select the external solid, press enter. At the select object prompt, select the internal solid, press enter. AutoCAD subtract the external solid from the internal solid. Change the overview to realistic to see the results. Change it back to 2D wireframe. Hold down your control key and type C on your keyboard. At the specified base point prompt, use the endpoint snap and snap to this vertex. Now select the external solid, move it to the 3D windows layer. Press escape to get out of the command. Select this window, this frame, right click and isolate hide objects. Now go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the line command. At the specified first point prompt, start a line from this point and move the mouse cursor down, click. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the offset command. At the specified offset distance prompt, type 1.5, press enter. Select this line offset to the right. Select this line offset to the left. Press escape to get out of the command. Zoom in into this area. Select the middle line and erase it. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the rectangle command. At the specified first corner point prompt, click on this area. At the specified opposite corner point prompt, click on this area, not this area, but this area. Press enter to start the rectangle command again. Start the rectangle from this corner and to this corner. Now, we need to get rid of the external rectangle. To do that, use a crossing window and select in this area. Hold down your shift key, click from this point and click into this area. Hit delete on your keyboard. Select the both rectangle. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the move command. At the specifying base point prompt, zoom in into this area and click. At the specifying second point prompt, move into the negative Z axis and type 0.5 inches, press enter. Press enter to repeat the move command again. Select this rectangle, press enter. At the specifying base point prompt, click on this area. Move into this direction and type 1.5, press enter to end the command. Hold down your shift key to orbit around. Select this line and hit delete on your keyboard. Now select both of this line, hold down the control plus shift and type C on your keyboard. At the specified base point prompt, click on this endpoint. Press escape to deselect the two objects. Select the two rectangles, go to the 3D tools tab, modeling panel, and select the extrude command. Move the mouse cursor into the Z direction, type 1.5, press enter. We select a single line during the extrusion process. So you select the surface. The result of the line is a surface. Click delete the surface. Now select this solid, and move them to the layer 3D windows. Press escape to get out of. Hold down the control key and type letter V on your keyboard. At the specified insertion point prompt, use the endpoint object snap and snap into this area. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 3 inches and press enter. Select this rectangle and offset it inside. Select this rectangle and offset it inside. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select this rectangle and hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the 3D tools tab, solid edit panel, and select the press pull command. at the select object or bounded area prompt, click on this area and move the mouse cursor into this direction and click. Repeat the same process in the other panel. Go to the visual style and change it back to realistic to see the results. Back to 2D wireframe, select this rectangle, go to the 3D tools tab, modeling panel, and select the extrude command. At the specifying height of extrusion prompt, move in this direction and type 0.25, press enter. Now zoom in into this area, select this solid, go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the move command. At the specifying base point prompt, use the endpoint object snap, the midpoint object snap, and snap to this edge, the midpoint of this edge. At the specifying second point prompt, use the midpoint object snap to snap at the midpoint of this edge. Now select the solid and this solid and move them to the window glass layer. Press escape to get out of command. Select this line and hit delete on your keyboard. Now change the visual style back to realistic. We still have a line, temporal line, that we need to delete. Use a window selection, click above this and move down and click. Hit delete on your keyboard. Right click the UCS wall. Right click in the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save button. Zoom in with your mouse and hold down the shift key with your middle mouse button to orbit around your drawing. Now the next, let's create the cutting wall for this area. To do that, go to right click the UCS, select the face option, move the mouse cursor and hover it to this face, press enter to accept. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the rectangle command. Zoom in into this area at the specified first corner point prompt, use the endpoint object snap and snap to this vertex. Move the mouse cursor to the opposite direction and hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit so that you have a better orientation. Click on this area. Go to the visual style, zoom out, and go to the visual style, change it to 2D wireframe. Now select the rectangle that you just draw, right click in the drawing area and isolate objects. Go to the view control and click the custom view. Select right. Zoom out to see your entire rectangle. First, let's draw the frame. After the frame, the division line. To draw the frame, the external frame, go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 2.5 inches. Press enter. Select this rectangle and offset it inside. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select the internal rectangle, hold down the control and the shift key and type letter C on your keyboard. At the specified insertion point prompt, click on this area. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select the two rectangles, go to the 3D tools tab, modeling panel, and select the extrude command. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Move the cursor into the negative Z direction and type 1 inch on your keyboard. Press enter. Zoom in into this area. Go to the 3D tools tab, solid edit panel, and select the subtract command. At the select object prompt, select the external solid and press enter. At the select object prompt, select the internal solid, press enter. AutoCAD subtract the internal solid from the external solid. Change your visual style to realistic to see the result. Select this solid, move it to the 3D windows layer. Press escape to get out of the command. Now we need to bring back the solid, that the rectangle that we copy, to window clipboard. Hold down your control key and type letter C on your keyboard. At the specified base point prompt, use the endpoint object snap and snap to the vertex of this solid. Now select this solid, right click, and isolate, hide objects. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 0.5, press enter. select the rectangle and offset it out. Press escape to get out of the corner. Zoom in into this area. Select the external rectangle. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the extrude corner. Go to the home tab, utility panel, and click the point style. Select the third option and leave all other settings as they are. Click OK. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and click this down arrow. Select the divide command. At the select object prompt, select this line. At the enter number of segment, enter 4, press enter. Press enter to repeat the command again. Move down and select this bottom line. Enter 4, press enter. Press enter to repeat the command again. At the select object to divide prompt, select this line. At the enter number of segment prompt, type 6, press enter. Press enter to repeat the command again. At select object to divide prompt, select this rectangle. At the enter number of segment form, enter 6 and press enter. Now go to the view control and click the custom view. Select right. Go to the status bar and click the down arrow after the snap button. Make sure that the node object snap is on. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the line command. Zoom in into this area. Snap from this node and move your mouse cursor down. Snap to this node. Press escape to get out of the command. Press enter to repeat the line command again. Snap from this node and snap into this node. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 0.75, press enter. At the select object to offset prompt, select this line, offset it to the left, select this line and offset it to the right, select this line, offset it above, select this line and offset it down. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the rectangle corner. At the specified first corner point prompt, zoom in into this area and snap at this intersection. Move the mouse cursor and zoom in into this area. Snap. Now select this line, and this line. Hit delete on the keyboard. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and start the rectangle command. Zoom in into this area. At the specified first corner point prompt, snap into this area. At the specified opposite corner prompt, zoom out and zoom in into this area. Snap. Now select this line, and hit delete on your keyboard. Select the external lines, zoom out and zoom in into this area, and select these lines. Hit delete on your keyboard. Select and delete this line. Now select this rectangle. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the copy command. At the specified base point prompt, use the node object snap to snap on this node. Now move the mouse cursor and snap to this point. And snap to this point. Press escape to get out of the command. Use a window selection to select this point and hit delete on your keyboard. Select this point again with a window selection and hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the copy command. At the select object prompt, select this rectangle, press enter. At the specifying base point prompt, use the node object snap and snap. At the specifying second point prompt, click on this point, and this point. Press escape to get out of the command. Use a window selection to select this point and this point. Hit delete on your keyboard. Select the external rectangle and hit delete. Now go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the rectangle command. At the specified first point prompt, click into this area and move the mouse cursor and snap to this area. Repeat the rectangle command again. Start from here to here. Press enter. From here to here. Press enter. From here to here. zoom in into this area. Use a window selection to select the rectangles that you just created. Now, go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the mirror command. At the specified first point of mirror line, hold down your shift key, right click, and select mid between two points. At the specified first point of midline, use the endpoint object map and snap here. At the specified second midpoint, click here. Now move your mouse cursor into this direction and click. Press enter. We need to adjust these rectangles. Now select this rectangle. Click on this clip. When it turns red, move it down and use the perpendicular object now. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the mirror command. Hold down your shift key, right click, mid between two points. Click here and here. Move the mouse cursor into this direction and click. Press enter. Select this rectangle, zoom in into this area, and try to select this rectangle. Hit delete on your keyboard. Use a window selection and hover the mouse cursor. Make sure that the crosshair lies in between this rectangle. Click. Move the mouse cursor to the opposite direction and click. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the mirror command. At the specified first point of mirror line, hold down your shift key, right click, and select mid between two points. Zoom in into this area. Click and move your mouse cursor. Click. Now move into this direction and click. Press enter. Type oops on your keyboard to bring back the deleted rectangles. Now select this rectangle. Zoom in at the intersection of the rectangle so that you can select the right ones. This rectangle. Zoom in at the intersection so that you can select the right one. Go to the 3D Tools tab, Modeling panel, and select the Extrude command. Hold down your Shift key and your middle mouse button to edit. Move the at the specified extrusion height, move to the negative Z direction and type 1 inch on your keyboard. Press enter. Hold down your shift key, select this solid, right click, select similar. AutoCAD select all the rectangles that you just created. Move them to the 3D window layer. Press escape to get out of the command. Zoom in into this area. Go to the Home tab, Draw panel, and start the line command. At the specifying first point prompt, click on this area. At the specifying next point prompt, move the mouse cursor into this direction and type 0.5 inches. Press enter to end the line command. Now select this solid, right click into the drawing area, select similar, and hit delete on your keyboard. Select all of these rectangles. Go to the 3D Tools tab, Modeling panel, and select the Extrude command. Move the mouse cursor into the negative Z direction and type 0.25. Press enter. Change the view to 2D wireframe. Select this panel, right click, select similar. Move them to the window glass layer. Now go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the Move command. Zoom in into this area. At the specifying this point prompt, use the midpoint object snap to snap the midpoint of this edge. and specify next point prompt. Use the endpoint object snap and snap to the endpoint of this line. Now type oops on your keyboard and press enter. Change the view back to realistic. Select this object, right click, select similar, right click, isolate object, hide object. Now select this rectangle, hit delete key on your keyboard. Right click the UCS word, right click into the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. Hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit around. Now we can't see through our glass. To do that, go to the layer properties manager. If you see any of this sign, the international no sign against any layer, click it to remove it. When you see this sign, it means that layer is set to non-plottable, so that object will not going to be plotted. That will create a problem when you want to plot your model. You know where the problem is. Leave this option only for the cabbage layer. For any other layer that have this option, make sure that you click the same icon to remove that international no sign. Now look for the window glass layer and change its transparent property from 0 to 75. Click OK. Close the layer properties manager. As you can see, now the layer is transparent. You can see the staircase inside your project. Go to the navigation bar and click the zoom extent button. Go to the view control and try to switch from one isometric view to the other to see the result so far. Alright, I'm going to end this tutorial here. You will go and continue to model your window with the same process that we used to create this window. If you found this tutorial useful, please click the like button and share it to your colleagues. If you have any question or you want a specific tutorial, please leave a comment below. If you want to follow along on this series or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class.